Hey, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be going over brakes on your Camaro ZL1, your Camaro ZL1 1LE, or your Camaro SS. Some of the part numbers will change, but the process is completely the same. I'm not going to do a how-to video, but I am going to give some helpful tips or things that you can watch out for if you have a mechanic or a speed shop do this work for you. But we did a complete refresh of the entire front brake system, and that's new rotors. The rotor hat is reusable. Completely rebuilt the front calipers, added speed bleeders. I have another video on that you can check out on the channel in more detail. And then all new pad hardware, brake pads, and added titanium shims. So this is a completely brand new brake system with when I put fresh fluid in it, it'll be as good or better than new. Additionally, we've installed CTS-V brake cooling ducts that will give all the airflow that's coming out of this secondary radiator, including the factory brake duct. But if you look here, here's the factory piece. It is like one third the size of the new CTS-V piece. A little camera magic here. But it has a exact same bolt pattern. So it's a direct fit. It takes about 15 minutes to install. So here's all the new hardware, both the pin, the spring, and the pad pins all are brand new. I'll put the part numbers for that in the description. You should change this. Not every pad change, but it's not good forever. So these have failed on people's cars, especially with track use. Speed bleeders, and then these nice, beautiful 0 hour rotor disc. First, you want to remove the brake line, which is you need an 11 millimeter socket to remove the banjo bolt that holds the brake line to the back of the caliper. It is going to drip, so you want to have a banjo clamp or something else like a vacuum cap that you can fit in there, because it is going to drip while it's disconnected and you're rebuilding the caliper. You can leave all the pad hardware in. You can just take that off when you get it in the bench. The main thing here, the main tip I can give you, is when you remove the 14 millimeter bolts, it's an 18 millimeter socket that's required. There are two of them that go from the caliper to the suspension here, the hub. But what you need to do is you need to use hand tools. Do not use hand tools. Do not use air tools. It says in the service manual not to use electric impact or air tools, because there is a possibility you could strip out the threads that are in the aluminum caliper. So don't do it. It's going to be hard to resist. Trust me, just take your time, do it the right way. So they crimp these the inner copper washer, the lock washer on. We're going to need to use a pair of pliers and hold that steady, and then we'll just use the wrench and basically unscrew the washer from the banjo bolt. There's really no good way to do it. You'll need two crush washers. I'll put the part number in the description below per brake caliper. So there's one on the inside and then one on the top of the banjo fitting. So that's what the crush washer looks like. You can see they actually deform them from the factory so they won't fall off. That's garbage. Remove the banjo bolt and we'll get that other washer off later. And brake fluid will drain out from where we took the brake hose off. So we want to take it off, pan under, just work it off. And then we want to hold it with the brake line fitting up. There is a just a inset Torx head screw that I've already taken out, and that's the only thing that holds the rotor on, and the rotor comes right off.
So this is the cleaned up brake calipers. We put it in the oil drain pan with a grit buster and got it as clean as we could get it. You can see here, this dust boot is completely missing. The piston is slightly exposed. These are pretty much gone. This one's actually not that bad. The outside ones are actually slightly worse than the inner. So what we'll do is we will pop off these dust boots with a small sharp screwdriver, and then we'll use air to extract the pistons. I know the Follow My Line channel, or the Follow My Line is a channel name, was asking about this process. I believe they were about to do it on their SS1 LE, so I'll spend a little bit more time going over this. So this is a setup before you apply air to the caliper. So we have a 2x4 that's cut just about the pad length of the pad, and then that is not thick enough to keep the pistons from like explosively leaving the caliper. So I have a old used brake pad that's about 2/3 gone, and that'll allow the pistons to come out and hit the pad. You want to make sure that the clamp doesn't interfere with the piston. So I like to put the clamp down by the small piston. And then I've got the bleeder screws in just finger tight. You don't want to leave these out. You will shoot any residual brake fluid out. So you also want to make sure that it's pointed in a good direction, like not towards your car. But let me get the air. We're going to be using 45 to 50 PSI air, and we're going to go very slowly. It should come right out. I used 100 PSI air the first time, and it was a little dramatic. So we're going to take it down a notch. So we have our air gun here and about 50 PSI. And so that worked perfect. They all came out. We'll just use some pliers or our fingers, and we'll pull them the rest of the way out past the inner seal, and then we'll flip this rig around and we'll do the other side. All right, here we go. We got our block in place. We got a little bit higher air pressure. That's not working. So we'll go in from the other side through the bleeder. So I've got a screw that'll block off the banjo fitting. This one's not going as easy as the other one. So I may have done the other side first. But I've removed one of the bleeder screws, and we'll put the air in the other side. There we go. Boom. That worked like a champ. So here's one of the large piston on the outboard side. It really doesn't have a lot of wear, but it's definitely not perfectly smooth. There's no real grooving, but you can see where it's been moving past where what was left of the dust seal. So there was probably debris and other stuff that was getting on this end of the piston. So it wasn't leaking, and so they were most likely good. So you need to remove the inner seals. So there's one in each piston machined hole. You don't want to use steel picks because they'll have a potential to scrape or scratch the inside of the aluminum machine surface. Here are a set of picks that I really like. They're Breakthrough Clean Technologies. They're a reinforced fiber pick. They're actually for gunsmithing, but they're great for O-ring removal. And so the larger ones are pretty easy to get to. You kind of want to get up underneath them and push them in, and then you can pull out the whole O-ring. The smaller ones, though, are a little bit stiffer, and I actually use the sharp end. I stab them, pick it up, and then get this other pick underneath it. So I'm just going to do it real quick, just show you how to do one of them, and because I'm probably going to have to spend a few minutes and have a lot of patience to get this one. So just up underneath it. Got it out with a few of fingers. I think it actually came back in. And so you want to take a clean, fresh brake fluid, and we're going to lubricate the bores, then we'll install the seals, and then we'll install the pistons. We're going to work this seal in. There's a groove that goes all the way around. It's a little bit of a pain. You want to make sure you have the right size. There's three different sizes for each side of the caliper. So I like to get the one, use one finger to get it in seated in the bottom of the groove. And then I like to work around and get the seal seated. Now it's fairly straightforward, but you want to make sure you don't get any twist in there. And if it starts to get kind of too out of shape in the piston bore, just pull it out and start again. So just and use your time, use your fingers, don't use a pick or something that could damage it. And just, you know, take your time, take it easy, and if you get frustrated, go have a beer. It's always good to have a lighted mechanics mirror. So there you go. Got that one in. Now just five more. All right, so we've got all six seals installed. I've just put a light coating of clean brake fluid on this first piston. We'll go in. We don't want to go all the way in. You want to push it just past the inner seal. You'll feel it, and then we will put the dust boot on and then seat everything. But it shouldn't take any force. There may be a little vacuum. Actually, we'll take a bleeder screw loose to help us out here. There, you just hear that little pop. Then we'll just go one by one down, and then we'll be ready for the dust seals. So the dust seal, you want to just kind of work this part around the groove in the piston, and then you just want to roll your fingers across it to get it to seat. This is one of the easier parts of the job. So just make sure that all of the dust boots are flush. Also, you want to make sure that they're not necessarily in contact with brake fluid. So you want to clean everything up really well. But man, what a difference from what it looked like. And the pistons move freely. We'll install speed bleeders in place of these. We'll get these grooves cleaned up a little bit, and then we'll button it back up. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you learned something, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.